Hello everyone, introduction to the microwave tubes. Microwave frequencies are the range of frequency in a gigahertz, that is 10 raised to 9 hertz. The wavelength of this frequency are measured in micrometer, so this frequency are called as a microwave frequencies. To generate this frequency or to amplify this frequency, we require a microwave tubes. Let us introduce one of the microwave tubes, that is a klystron tube. The learning objective is to introduce the basic principle of operation of microwave klystron tube and to make the student understand the construction and working of the klystron tube. After observing this video lecture, students are able to understand the working principle of the klystron tube. Also, students will realize the different parts of the klystron tube. Klystron is a power amplifier tube which is used to amplify the weak microwave energy to the high power level for a radar transmitter. As there are different types of the klystron tube, single cavity klystron, two cavity klystron, multi cavity klystron, so these klystrons are classified based on high power, large size, high stability, high gain and high operating voltages. The basic working principle of this klystron tube is a velocity modulation, in which the speed of the electrons is being changed according to the input waveform to produce a microwave energy. Here, the beam of the electrons are being formed, which are give up the energy in a form of microwave. The klystron is referred as a linear beam tube because the direction of the electric field that accelerates the electron beam. They are used in operational radars like next generation weather radars, terminated Doppler weather radar. Let us see the construction of the microwave tube. The microwave two cavity klystron tube. It consists of a two cavity. One is a puncture cavity, one is the catcher cavity. The puncture cavity and the catcher cavity are separated by the drift space. The bunching of the electrons takes place in a drift space. Cathode is kept at a high potential, a high negative potential with respect to the anode. The signal which has to be amplified is given at the input of the puncture cavity and the output is being collected at a catcher cavity. This signal is an amplified signal. Now, how the bunching takes place is explained by Apple gate diagram. For that, we will be considering the three electrons which are being transmitted, emitted from the cathode. Let us consider that three electrons. Earlier electrons, reference electrons and later electrons, which have been represented by EE, ER and EF. These electrons are being affected by the input field, by the sinusoidal input field, negative field, zero field and positive field. The electrons which is affected by the zero field is considered as a reference electrons. Electrons which is affected by the negative field is considered as a earlier electron. Electrons which is affected by the positive field is considered to be a later electrons. The electrons which is affected by the negative field, the zero field, that is reference electrons, will be no effect on that speed. It will move with the same speed which is emitted by the cathode, that is V0. The earlier electron which is affected by the negative field, due to its effect of the negative field, its speed decreases. Then it will move with the slow velocity and the later electron which is affected by the positive field, its speed increases. In this way, at certain point, earlier electron, later electrons and the reference electrons will come together and form a bunch of electrons which is being collected at the catcher cavity. The working can be represented in this diagram. This is a space which is showing as a drift space. Here the electric field is directed towards the right so that electron enters from the left side get retarded. The electric field is now directed towards the left, thus accelerating the electrons coming from the left. These accelerated electrons are going to bump onto the previously slow moving retarded electron. So the bunching can be seen taking place in the mid of the klystron. A big bunch of the electron thus formed can be seen moving toward the catcher cavity. The electron bunch passing through the catcher cavity introduce a sinusoidal oscillation whose magnitude will depends upon the input amount of bunching that takes place. This sinusoidal oscillation introduced are conceptually similar to those that are introduced in a class C amplifier. Physical appearance of the klystron too. Pause this video, see the working principle, and at each point observe it. At the first point, one, the electron beam produces flow of electrons. At point number 2, the bunching cavity regulates the speed of the electron so that they arrive in the buncher at the output cavity. At point number 3, the bunches of the electron excite the microwave in the output cavity of the klystron. At point number 4, the microwave flow into the waveguide which transform to be a accelerator. At a point 5th, the electrons are absorbed in a beam stop. These are the assignment questions, that are, what are the different parts of the microwave tube? How bunching cavity takes place in the cavity. This assignment has to be submitted on the Moodle platform. Thank you.